You see here again. Another example about energy and sound. So here you have the sonotest, that's also a fantastic instrument that makes invisible energies of your chakras, for example, makes them audible, you hear them. Where you have more energy on your chakras or certain chakras are more active, you would hear the sound will amplify itself, will increase. And where you have a little problem, that can be psychological problem or physical problem inside, outside, it would absorb the sound. So it's really very nice. And you see, when you see on the hieroglyphs of ancient buildings, like the around the temples, around the pyramids, you see all kind of tools that you don't know what it's for. I think a part of those tools are just kind of tuning forks, you see, tuning systems, wave systems to help to heal. An example, listen. We will do it on me as a experiment. Do it again. You see here, you have heard at this level I had more energy, the sound increases, and there I had little less energy compared to there, and the sound was absorbed. And when the sound was absorbed and I come back here, the sound increased again. That's very interesting, because if you are in tune with certain energies, you see, you can create more energy. If you have like 100 tuning forks at the same frequency, they would all vibrate, even if you just tuckle on one tuning fork. It's all about resonance. Energy is about resonance. If you put something in the same resonance as light, you could capture the light frequency. If you put something with sound at the same, like if those tubes were at the same frequencies of the sound we hear from the other tent, they would begin to ring. But they don't, because they are not at the same frequencies. So it's all energy that is there all around us. And so that is a tool that everybody can use. Even somebody, I don't believe in kind of energy like this or this. You don't have to believe, you just have to listen, to look, and you would see. And you cannot tell there's nothing, there is something. Because an example, if you have eaten something bad, you would see it would absorb the sound. If you have a sore throat, you would see it would absorb the sound on your level of your throat. You cannot hide, the energy is there. And that's also very important, because when you are more intuitive, more aware, it will be a lot more difficult to hide things or to lie, because you would feel directly it's truth or it's not truth, or he is hiding something or not. If everybody would have instant telepathy, all the politicians would have to say the truth, otherwise they will be not taken serious. It's just as simple as that, everybody. And that would change the world instantly. If everybody come back to his own energy and intuition and everything, it would change the world instantly, because you would see the truth in the things. You would follow the right paths, your purpose, your life purpose. About sound again, sound structures have a structuring effect. You have the magnetic field, the earth, there's everywhere. You take a compass up, you can capture that magnetic field everywhere. That's magnetic energy that is everywhere. And I think, like the dowsers, the phones, silent, like the dowsers too, they can, with their rods, they feel like changes in the magnetic fields, but very subtle changes like this. So an example here is a line. I don't know what it is, but there is something. Here we have seen that there's a cross, because I went like this, and I think there's a cross of two lines. Well, you can also hear the difference with the sound. If you go over it, you would hear it. It's a kind of energy that is there. It's like a grid on earth. And sometimes it's good to be on a certain crossing points, but sometimes it's not good. People are sometimes making them sick on being on places that are not good for them. It depends. So it's very interesting. And so I think the sound has also electromagnetic properties. And I have read that in certain Asian, or I think Chinese articles, such scientific articles about sound. And they were talking about electromagnetic properties. There's like a story about the turtle, you see? The structure of the turtle, well, if you put sound on sand, certain frequencies, you find back the same shapes as you find on the turtle or in the electromagnetic field of the earth. And that's very interesting, because it's like sound shapes things or give form, structure. Sound is an information. Our thoughts is an information.